Welcome to Study Room. Friends, this video is on Small Savings Scheme's latest rules based on GSPR 2018 and 19 and subsequent SB orders. We have made 25 questions and this is the first series. Next series will come soon. Time deposit investment should be option A, minimum rupees 100 and multiples of rupees 100. Option B, minimum rupees 1000 and multiples of rupees 100. Option C, minimum rupees 1000 and in multiples of rupees 1000. Option D, any amount. The correct answer is option B, that is minimum of rupees 1000 and in multiples of rupees 100. Question number 2. Pledge fee is how much? Options A, rupees 5 plus GST. Option B, rupees 1 plus GST. Option C, rupees 100 plus GST. Option D, rupees 50 plus GST. The correct answer is option C, rupees 100 plus GST. Question number 3. Charges for transfer of accounts from one account office to another. Options. Option A, rupees 5 plus GST. Option B, rupees 10 plus GST. Option C, rupees 100 plus GST. Option D, rupees 50 plus GST. The correct answer is option C, rupees 100 plus GST. Question number 4. Pledge release fee. Option A, rupees 5 plus GST. Option B, rupees 10 plus GST. Option C, rupees 100 plus GST. Option D is free of cost. The correct answer is pledge release fee is free of cost. Question number 5. Nomination is options A, mandatory for saving bank account only. B, mandatory for all small savings schemes. Option C, mandatory for MIS and TD only. Option D, not mandatory. The correct answer is mandatory for all small savings schemes. Question number 6. Nomination for minor accounts. Options A, mandatory for savings bank account only. Option B, mandatory for all small savings schemes. Option C, mandatory for MIS and TD only. Option D, not mandatory. The correct answer is option B, mandatory for all small savings scheme, even if it is a minor account. Question number 7. Maximum nomination allowed. Option A, 1. B, 4, C, 6, D, no limit. The correct answer is option B, 4. Question number 8. Witness for nomination in case of account opened by literate person. Options A, witness not required. Option B, 1 witness enough. Option C, 2 witness required. Option D, to be identified by postal staff. The correct answer is option A, witness not required. This is account opened by literate person. Question number 9. Witness for nomination in case of account opened by illiterate person. Options A, witness not required. Option B, 1 witness enough. Option C, 2 witness required. Option D, to be identified by postal staff. The correct answer is option C, 2 witness required. Question number 10. Fee for cancellation of nomination. Options A, rupees 10 plus GST. Option B, rupees 50 plus GST. Option C, rupees 100 plus GST. Option D, free of cost. The correct answer is rupees 50 plus GST. Question number 11. Fee for statement of accounts. Options rupees 20 plus GST, option B rupees 50 plus GST, option C rupees 100 plus GST, option D rupees free. The correct answer is option A, rupees 20 plus GST. It may be any number of times, each time rupees 20 plus GST. Question number 12, fee for duplicate passbook, all schemes. Options A, rupees 20 plus GST, option B, rupees 50 plus GST, option C, rupees 100 plus GST, option D, free. The correct answer is rupees 50 plus GST. Now, duplicate passbook rates applicable for all the schemes. This has to be noted. Question number 13. When account holder becomes NRI subsequently, opening of account. Options A. Account cannot be continued. Option B. Should be closed immediately. Option C. Can continue and can be extended as normal account holder. Option D. Can continue the existing account but cannot extend. The correct answer is option D. Can continue the existing account till maturity but cannot be extended. Question number 14. When account holder ceases to be a citizen of India, what will happen to the account? Option A. Account can be continued. Option B. Account shall be closed or deemed closed with interest up to last day of preceding month. Option C. Can continue and can be extended as normal account holder. Option D. Can continue the existing account but cannot extend. The correct answer is option B. Account shall be closed or deemed closed with interest up to last day of preceding month. Question number 15. Following saving bank account discontinued. Options A. Pension account. Option B. Basic saving account. Option C. Zero balance account. Option D. No interest account. Option E. All the above. The correct answer is option E. All the above. Question number 16. Number of joint account allowed for an individual in respect of saving bank account. Options A. One single account and one joint account. Option B. One single account and multiple joint account. Option C. Two single account and two joint account. Option D. One single account and two joint account. The correct answer is option A. One single account and one joint account. Question number 17. Number of individual allowed in joint account in respect of saving bank account. This is different from some 16 questions. Please read carefully. Question number 17. I am reading once again. Number of individual allowed in joint account in respect of saving bank account. Options A. Maximum 5. Option B. Maximum 4. Option C. Maximum 3. Option D. Maximum 2. The correct answer is option D. Maximum 2. 2 persons can open joint account as per SB is concerned. Not more than 2%. Question number 18. Minimum amount to open SB account with checkbook. Options A. 0. Option B. Rupees 50. Option C. Rupees 100. Option D. Rupees 500. The correct answer is option D, rupees 500. Question number 19. Minimum amount to open SB account without checkbook. This is different from previous question. Please read carefully. This is without checkbook. That is minimum amount to open SB account without checkbook. Option A, rupees 0. Option B, rupees 50. Option C, rupees 100. Option D, rupees 500. The correct answer is option D, rupees 500. Now whether the account is with checkbook or without checkbook, minimum amount to open an account is rupees 500. Question number 20. Minimum amount for subsequent deposit in SBI account. Options rupees 10. Option B rupees 50. Option C rupees 100. Option D rupees 500. Here the correct answer is option A rupees 10. Question number 21. Minimum amount of withdrawal allowed in SB account. Option A rupees 10. Option B rupees 50. Option C rupees 100. Option C. Option D rupees 500. The correct answer is option B rupees 50. Question number 22. Maintenance charges per annum if minimum balance not maintained in SB account. Options. Option A rupees 10 plus GST. Option B rupees 50 plus GST. Option C rupees 100 plus GST. Option D rupees 500 plus GST. So the correct answer is rupees 100 plus GST. If the amount becomes zero, the account will be closed automatically. Question number 23. Charges per check leaves beyond 10 free check leaves in a year. Options. Option A rupees 2 plus GST. Option B rupees 5 plus GST. Option C rupees 10 plus GST. Option D rupees 50 plus GST. The correct answer is option A rupees 2 plus GST. Question number 24. Charges for dishonored check. Options A rupees 20 plus GST. Option B rupees 50 plus GST. Option C rupees 100 plus GST. Option D rupees 500 plus GST. The correct answer is rupees 100 plus GST. Question number 25 and the last question in this video. Minimum denomination for investment in RD account. Minimum denomination for investment in RD account. Option A rupees 20. Option B rupees 50. Option C rupees 100. Option D rupees 500. The correct answer is option C rupees 100. Below 100 you cannot open the account. Friends, thanks for watching Study Room. I think you are getting benefit from Study Room. Let's prepare for the exams together. If you want to get more notifications from Study Room, please click on the subscribe button below the video when you are watching YouTube. It is completely free and it helps you to get instant notification from Study Room. Thank you, friends.